Today we'll discuss about the remaining part of the packaging of the pharmaceutical products. As we have discussed earlier about the various packaging materials which are to be used or which is being used in the packaging of the pharmaceuticals were plastics and the glass. In this lecture we'll cover the remaining material or the particular things which are being used to prepare the packagings of the pharmaceutical containers. So in this category, that next one is the metals. Metals are used for construction of the containers. The metals commonly used for this purpose are of aluminium, tin, plated steel, stainless steel, tin and the lead. The advantages if we are using the metals they are impermeable to light, moisture and the gases. They are made into rigid, unbreakable containers by impact extrusion. They are light in weight compared to glass containers. Labels can be printed directly onto that surface, and it has disadvantages like they are expensive as well as they react with certain chemicals. The collapsible tubes are also available for the packaging of the ointments or the creams like that. These collapsible metal tubes is an attractive container which permits controlled amount to be dispensed easily with good reclosure and adequate protection of the product. It is light in weight and unbreakable and lends itself to high speed automatic filling operations. Means the productivity of filling of that particular dosage form is enhanced, or you can say that the more number of this material or these tubes can be packed, and ultimately which results into the higher production of that packaging of that particular product. The most commonly used collapsible tubes are of tin, aluminium and the lead. The tin containers are preferred for the food, pharmaceuticals and any product for which purity is considered. Tin is the most chemically inert of all collapsible metal tubes which are being used for that production. The next is the aluminium. Aluminium tubes offer significant savings in product shipping costs because of their lightweight. They are attractive in nature. The lead is the another one which leads, and it has the lowest cost of all tube metals and is widely used for non-food products such as adhesives, inks, paints and the lubricants. Lead should never be used alone for anything taken internally because of the risk of lead poisoning. With internal linings, lead tubes are used for the products such as the chloride toothpaste. Apart from that, fibrous materials can also be used for the packaging of the pharmaceuticals. These fibrous materials are the important part of the pharmaceutical packaging. Fibrous materials include papers, labels, cartons, bags, outers, trays for shrink wraps, layer boards on pallets, etc. The applications as well as the advantages of the cartons are they increases the display area of the product. It provides better stacking for display of stock items. You can assemble the leaflets into that. It provides physical protection, especially to the items like metal collapsible tubes, fiber boards, outers either as solid or corrugated board. Also find substantial application for the bulk shipments. The regenerated cellulose films, trade names like cellophane and the rheophane, is used for either individual cartons or to assemble a number of cartons. Here in this slide that you can see that the compound fiber board and the paper which are being used for this manufacturing of this product. Apart from that, films can also be used, foils can also be used, and the laminates can also be used for the packaging of the pharmaceuticals. Basically, the regenerated cellulose film based on viscose, which is chemical used for manufacturing of the rayon, and the laminating two or more types of films. The cellulose coatings, foil, and the paper play a very different role, such as supportive barrier, heat seal and the decorative. And for example, that you can have the aluminium foil which are widely used in the packaging of the food also in the household. This aluminium foil is in the thinnest gauge, offers the best barrier properties, these are not approached even by the most impermeable plastics. Metallization, a relatively new process whereby particles of metal are let down onto a surface under vacuum, can significantly improve the barrier properties of a material, but these do not approach the properties of a pure foil. In the new technology, which is known as that co-extrusion, a number of plastic plies are extruded in combination to produce cheaper laminations. The uses of the films, foils and laminates are in the packaging of strip packs, manufacturing of the blister packs, sachets, diaphragms, seals for the bottles and the liners for boxes, either attached or loose bag in box system and the bags. The foil blisters, when sealed with the metal foil cover, the blisters can provide a hermetic pack, that is an isolated system which excludes any exchange of gases between the product and the surrounding atmosphere. You can have the example of the alu foil, which is made up of the aluminium, and it is the best pharmaceutical packaging film for tablets, capsules, which is taking place of the PVC film. This alu foil have the characteristics that it is applicable to the tablets, capsules, pills, etc. It is good substitute for the PVC sheets. No cracking is there. Delamination or the pinholes will not be observed in that. It has the quite good blocking properties, effectively protecting drugs from water, vapor, oxygen and the ultraviolet rays. It can extend the storage period of the drugs, so ultimately the stability of the product will be achieved up to that shelf life of that product. It is particularly suitable for packaging moisture sensitive drugs or those sold in the hot and the humid areas. The taking out a part of the drugs from the drug board without any impact on other well-packaged drugs. It is used by cold molding packaging machines. It is shaped easily by changing the mold. It provides nice appearance which can ultimately upgrade the drug's image. Apart from that, these materials, that rubbers are also being used for the packaging of the pharmaceuticals, especially you can observe this in the injectable vials where these elastomers are being used. This is excellent material for forming seals used to form closures such as the rubber bunks for vials, or in similar applications such as the gaskets in aerosol cans. The various categories of the rubbers are there. Natural rubbers are there and the synthetic rubbers are there, which have their own advantages over this. The rubber is used mainly for the construction of closer meant for the vials, transfusion fluid bottles, dropping bottles and as washers in many other types of the product. Butyl rubber is mainly used. This has the advantage that permeability to the water paper is means that it's good. Water absorption is very low. They are relatively cheaper compared to the other synthetic rubbers. It has disadvantages like that slow decomposition takes place above 130 degree centigrade. Oil and the solvent resistance is not very good. Apart from that, butyl, that nitrile rubbers are also being used, which has the advantage like it is oil resistant due to the polar nitrile group, and it is heat resistance also. The disadvantage with nitrile rubber is that absorption of the bactericide and the leaching of the extractives are considerable in this category when you are using these nitrile rubbers. The chloroprene rubbers are also being used with the advantage of having oil resistant heat stability, which is very good in this. Apart from that, silicone rubbers are being used because they are heat sensitive, heat resistant. extremely low absorption and the permeability of the water can be there. Excellent aging characteristics. This has the disadvantage that they are very expensive. The tamper resisting, the tamper resistant packaging is also available in the market for the various pharmaceutical products. This requires or that it is the requirement for the tamper resistant packaging is now one of the major consideration in the development of the packaging for pharmaceutical products. The tamper resistant packages is one having an indicator to entry in which, if missing, can reasonably be expected to provide visible evidence to consumers that tampering has occurred. It means that you can understand that when you are going to the retail shop and buying the medicines, and if you are watching, if you observe that the product is being tampered, like that some manipulations have been done in that, or it is opened and again it is sealed, so that means if it is activities you observe while purchasing of the medicines in that condition, you can consider that case some changes have been done in that original product. So for avoiding that, the pharmaceutical companies are packaging their product in the tamper resistant packagings. The tamper resistant package is one having an indicator to entry in which, if missing, can reasonably be expected to provide visible evidence to consumers that tampering has occurred. That FDA, Food and Drug Administration, approves the following configurations as tamper resistant packaging: the film wrappers, blister packages, strip packages, bubble pack, shrink seals, and bands oil, paper, plastic, pouches, bottle seals, tap seals, breakable caps, aerosol containers. Now coming to the film wrappers. The film wrapping has been used extensively over the years for the products requiring package integrity or environmental protection. You can categorize into the three categories. One is the end folded wrapper, film seal wrapper, and the shrink wrapper. The end folded wrapper is formed by passing the product into a sheet of overwrapping film, which forms the film around the product and folds the edges in a gift wrap fashion. The folded areas are sealed by pressing against a heated bar. The materials commonly used for this purpose are cellophane and the polypropylene. Film wrappers, you can understand that this end folded wrappers, when you are packing like the tablets, that that folded area which is being sealed either by pressing against a heated bar, means the arrangement is like that. Dyes are there where you are supplying this films and the product is being packed into that, and it is compressed or it is sealed by either providing the heated bar or you can use another manners for sealing up that one. The film seal wrappers are there. These are the seals found by the crimping the film together and sealing together the two inside surfaces of the film, producing a film seal. Film seal is superior than end folded wrapper with good seal integrity. The overwrap can be removed or opened by tearing the wrapper. The third one is the shrink wrapper. This shrink wrapper concept involves the packaging of the product in a thermoplastic film that has been stretched and oriented during its manufacture. An L-shaped sealer seals the overwrap. The major advantage of this type of wrapper are the flexibility and low cost of packaging equipment. Coming to the blister packaging, that this blister packaging provides excellent environmental protection and the efficacious appearance of that product. It provides user functionality in terms of convenience, child resistance, and tamper resistance. The blister package is formed by heat softening a sheet of the thermoplastic resin and vacuum drying, which softens the sheet of plastic into a contoured mold. And after cooling, the sheet is released from the mold and proceeds to the filling station of the machine. It is then lidded with heat sealable backing material. Peelable backing material is used to meet the requirements of child resistance packaging. The material such as polyester or the paper is used as a component of the backing lamination. Means that you can understand that one side that these blisters have been developed by using that sheet or the laminate, and where this heated, this is being heated, temperature is being raised, and it passes through that the molds, and it achieve the specific shape which is required for the packaging of your product. And when it develops that the product is supplied from the another hopper, if it is in the case of the your tablets, and it will be placed into that, and the another sheet will be passes from the lower die, and it will get sealed by using that either the heated or the any other means, and it is being sealed. So likewise that blister is developed and it is getting packed. So that the material such as the polyesters or the paper is used as a component of the backing lamination. The materials commonly used for the thermoformable blisters are PVC, polyethylene combinations, polystyrene and the polypropylenes. Blister packs are commonly used as unit dose packaging for pharmaceutical tablets, capsules or lozenges. You can see here in the picture that these blister package tablets are shown in this picture. These packs consist of two principal components. One is a formed base web creating the cavity inside which the product fits, and the leading foil for dispensing the product out of the pack. There are two types of forming the cavity in a base web sheet: thermoforming and the cold forming. Thermoforming is in the case of the thermoforming, a plastic film or sheet is unwound from the reel and guided through a preheated station on the blister line. The temperature of the preheating plates, upper and the lower plates, is such that the plastic will soften and become moldable. Whereas in the case of the cold formation or the cold forming procedure, that an aluminium based laminate film is simply pressed into a mold by means of a stamp. The aluminium will be elongated and maintain the form shape. The advantage of the cold formation, these foil blisters, is that the use of aluminium is offering a near complete barrier for water and oxygen, allowing an extended product expiry date. The disadvantages of the cold form foil blisters are that the slower speed of production compared to the thermoforming, and the lack of the transparency of the package, and the larger size of the blister card. Here you can see that blister package of the dosage form tablets are there. The aluminium foils for the blister package are generally being used widely, that since it is suitable for the blister packaging of the pharmaceutical products, specifically for the tablets, capsules, etc. Now coming to the another part of this presentation, that is strip package. The strip package is a form of unit dose packaging that is commonly used for the packaging of the tablets and the capsules. The strip package is formed by feeding two webs of a heat sealable flexible through heated crimping rollers. The product is dropped into the pocket formed prior to forming the final set of seals. A continuous strip of packet is formed in general. The strip of packets is cut into the desired number of the packets. The different packaging materials which are generally being used for the strip packaging is paper, or it may be polyethylene, or it may be foil, or it may be PVC. Coming to the next one, that is the bottle seals. A bottle may be made tamper resistant by bonding an inner seal to the rim of the bottle in such a way that the product can only be attained by destroying the seal. You might have observed in the bottles of syrups, like if we take the example of any liquid preparation or the liquid dosage form like suspension or emulsion or some solution, you will find that it is tightly closed, and when you have to use that, you have to break the seal. Means there are two parts like that, which is sealed bottle, which is known as a bottle seals. it means that it is intact and there is no tampering is being done, or it is not open, or it is not changed like that. So if it is intact, it means that it is pure and in original form. If it is broken, it means that you cannot trust on that product and you can refuse to take from that medical shop. Typically, glassine liners are 2-ply laminations used in 2 sheets of glassine paper bounded together with wax or adhesives. For pressure sensitive inner seals, pressure sensitive adhesives is coated on the surfaces of the inner seal as an encapsulated adhesives. Apart from that, tape seals are also available. It involves the application of the glued or the pressure sensitive tape or label around or over the closure of the package, which is to be destroyed to obtain the product. The paper used most often is a high density lightweight paper with poor tearing strength. Coming to the next one, that is sealed tubes. The collapsible tubes used for the packaging are constructed of metal, plastic or laminations of the foil paper and the plastics. Metal tubes are still used for products that required high degree of barrier protection. The most of these are made of aluminium. Extruded plastic tubes are widely used for products that are compactable and the limited protection of the plastic. Here are some symbols which are generally being used on the packages and the labels. You can see here that the many types of the symbols for packages labeling are nationally and internationally standardized for the product certification as well as for the trademark or for the proof of the purchase. Like that, you can have this fragile, there's this way up. You might have observed these symbols which are generally used on the packages of that particular product, outer cover you can say rather, and on that it is mentioned that it is fragile, don't misuse like that. So these are the few examples of that by which you can understand the property of the product which is being packed in that. Thank you very much for your patient hearing.